Hey guys, how are you all doing today? My name is Franchise Fanatic, and welcome back to the channel. And today what I have for you guys is another movie review, and today we are tackling Brightburn, the basically evil Superman origin story by James Gunn, the guy who made Guardians of the Galaxy, which is super duper awesome. And I'm extremely hyped to tell you that this is my first horror movie. I've never seen a horror movie before. I know, right? I've never seen anything. I've never seen Aladdin. I've never seen a horror movie. What's wrong with me? But apparently something's not wrong anymore because I did see it, and it's a very good movie actually. A lot of people are just liking it. I'm not quite sure why. But before I get into the review, I do want to say that this movie was made with a $7 million budget, which is very, very cheap, right? I mean, comparing that to Endgame or Infinity War or even Shazam or Aquaman, you know, those are so expensive to make, and they make that money tenfold. But Brightburn was $7 million, so James Gunn and everyone involved, David Yerovsky or whoever was, I think that's how you pronounce the name, Yerovsky, the director, you guys did a great job making such a small budget, but you guys made a great movie, which I'm sure is going to surpass $7 million, I would hope. But yeah, so let's get right into this. This is essentially, Brightburn is essentially a horror movie, a superhero horror movie, where basically, if you know the Superman origin story, right, which is of course DC, where you have a ship crashed down in Kansas, and the Kent family, Martha and Thomas Kent, I think, or something, I think, Thomas Kent, one of the Kents, the ship crashes down, right, and then you get baby Clark Kent, or baby Kal-El, you know, they call him Clark, and, I mean, come on, you guys know this by now. If you don't, again, it's, this movie, this plot for Brightburn is literally beat for beat Superman, except that A, they don't use the DC logo, and B, they don't use the term Kent, or Superman, or Kal-El, or Krypton, or Kryptonite, or anything that you would associate with Superman, they don't do that. So this is very much its own entity, even though it is a rip-off of Superman. I mean, it's literally Superman, I mean, from the plot. So basically, the baby comes down in a ship, right? And the Briars, one is played by Elizabeth Banks, the mom who was Rita Repulsa in Power Rangers. She's also Lucy, or Wildstyle, in the Lego Movie franchise, which is very cool. She might be in other things, that's what I know her by most. And of course the dad, which I actually don't know, but he did a great performance. He was kind of a, I don't know. He did a great performance. I'll talk about him in a second. But, so yeah, the ship crashes, right, and they're like, oh, we can't have kids, so what are we going to do? We're going to adopt. Oh, well, wait a minute, there's a ship in our backyard. So they kind of wait, and they go outside, and they see this baby, right? They adopt it. And the movie starts out very much not like a horror movie, right? It literally, and of course no spoilers, but it starts out very happy and jovial, you know? You have this family, you can't have a kid, and finally they have a kid, you know, it's perfect, and they're celebrating, you know, their life together, there's baby pictures and baby videos and all that, it's all great, right, it's fantastic, they're happy. But then, Brandon Breyer, whatever you want to say, he's sleeping in bed at night, right, and then, see, this is weird, I kind of have to spoil a Superman movie, I think it was Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, or Superman 3, you know what it is, it's Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, not a great movie, okay. Christopher Reeve was good in that movie, but not a great movie. If you remember in that film, spoiler alert, I guess, from 1975 or whatever, 80-something, Superman goes to find his mothership, essentially, right? The asteroid thing that carried him to Earth in Kansas. And if you remember Superman, Kal-El, he grabs the kryptonite from the ship, but it weakens him and it hurts him. So there's a lot of things from Superman lore that take place in this movie, and that's really, really cool in my opinion. So, again, once this kid, Brandon Breyer, is sleeping at night, the ship that, of course, his parents locked up, starts going crazy, and he starts going around, going crazy in his bed, and it turns out that the ship is telling him these messages in this you know, alien language, take the world. And that's when he starts losing his cool. Now, me and my friend were actually talking about this, me and Alan, we were talking, and we said, was Brandon, right, was he evil from the beginning, like, from conception or what, alien conception, or was he, evil, that's funny, evil from the, you know, the ship, and I don't know, I think it's a ship, because, again, I don't really think this is a spoiler, but he's convulsing in bed, and he gets these messages in his head, and after he gets those messages, he starts going crazy. And he starts, once puberty hits, there's this girl that he likes in school, so he stalks her. But it's not like how, you know, someone would stalk her in, you know, human form. I mean, no. He goes to her freaking bedroom and spies on her and puts weird messages on the computer and gives her flowers. So it's very strange, right? He's doing all these weird things. He's inhibiting these super strength and all that. You know, he has laser vision. Essentially Superman, again, duh. But he starts chewing on forks. I mean, and nothing hurts him. And even the Breyers, the family, were talking, the mom and dad, they're like, this kid's never been hurt. He's never had a scratch. He's never had a bruise. He's never been injured, never broken a bone, nothing. What's up, you know? And, of course, the parents don't tell him that he's an alien. So the plot, again, it's very much like a Superman story. In fact, it's 100% a Superman story. But it's not Superman, it's not DC, and it's from a pure superhero horror angle. And it works really well. I mean, yeah, the plot is generic, but if you know Superman, the plot doesn't matter, you know? It's generic, yeah, but it's fun, and it's cool, and it's different. It's really on the flip side of what Superman would do, and that's really cool. So again, plot generic, but it is what it is. Let's go for the acting now. The acting is something that I really like. In horror movies, and again, this is my first horror movie, but I'm a movie buff. I know a lot about horror movies. In a horror film, you need to have good acting. If you don't have good acting, you don't have a good horror film. I don't care if your special effects are good, if your CGI is good, if the sound design or the special effects are good, whatever. If you have bad actors, you have a bad horror movie, plain and simple, because then you're not invested. You don't care. You don't care what happens to these characters. Frankly, though, Brightburn has great acting. Now, again, I can't say, oh, you know, this has great acting, but The Conjuring 2 doesn't, or Annabelle, because I haven't seen those. But from what I could gather, they have good acting. But you've seen a bad horror movie if you know what I mean. But again, this movie, the little kid who played what's his face, Brandon Breyer, Brightburn, he did a phenomenal job. I mean, again, these young actors they're proving themselves to be really good. I mean, just look at the Harry Potter movies and look at a bunch of other films where you have these little kids. And sure, Harry Potter and Hermione and Ron, they grew up, but I mean, when they were little, they were good actors, you know? You rarely see that, and that's really cool to see, and it's, because it is so rare, it's great, you know? It's really, really cool. So, the guy who played Brandon did a great job, and he's a freaky little kid. He's a freaky little SOB, I'll tell you that right now. The dad and the mom, again, Elizabeth Banks and the dad figure, he did a great job. They acted like a real mom and dad would. The dad defending the kid, but then the dad saying, okay, you know, maybe this kid's a little left up. And then the mom going, I'm defending you no matter what. I don't care if you did that. I'm defending you. But then, of course, no spoilers, but things happen around the third act, and shit happens. I'll tell you that. A lot of crazy stuff happens. But again, acting through the board is very, very good. I loved it. It's phenomenal. There wasn't a character that I thought was, did a bad job. The parent figures, normally parents in these movies can be kind of, retards. They're like, you just look at it, you know, they're constantly stupid, and I get it was a different thing, but, you know, the adult figures in this movie were really well played, and they were really, they were good characters. I think every character in this movie was really good. So again, plot generic, but pretty good, acting really good. The script, I didn't have any issues with the script. I thought it was really well played. I thought the screenwriter did a great job, or screenwriters. Everyone did a great job with that. Well, again, I feel weird making these movie reviews and not saying that much negative, but honestly, guys, I like this movie. I really loved it. And again, it was on the ride home, it was kind of hard to think of negatives. Now, there are a few, okay? There's a few editing mishaps. If you noticed when I did my Aladdin review, I said that there were a few editing mishaps. But essentially, there's one scene. Remember that scene from the trailer, right? Where the lady gets glass in her eye, and she's in the back of the store, the diner. And then you see Brandon, right? In his Superman Kylo Ren looking mask thing, and then he just goes like that, just goes like here's her, and he just goes, you know, like, it's like that. It was really, really quick. In the trailer, of course, the trailer keeps going, so it's fine, but in the movie, it cuts to black, which is fine, but then really after that, boom, next scene, and everyone's all happy, and Brandon, you know, the killer is literally eating cereal or something, so I think that editing choice was a little weird. And then there's a scene where they're talking as a family, and then it really quickly cuts to them in a bar. It's just, I don't know. For being such a great edited movie, I mean, the editing is superb. The sound design is brilliant. When things happen and, you know, limbs come apart and, you know, blood and everything, and as weird as that sounds, it sounds really real and it sounds gross. I mean, the scene where Brandon's chewing on a fork and the dad whips the fork out of his mouth, you hear the fork scratch his teeth, and it's brutal. The sound is really good. And that's another thing that you need in a horror movie. You need good sound effects, and this movie had that tenfold. Now, again, so we have the editing, a little bit strange, and then we have my other negative, which is very, 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 not a bad negative at all. You know, it's not like I'm gonna give it an F for this. I can't speak on that. I'm shocked how good this movie was. But the CGI. Now again, the CGI, we're dealing with a $7 million budget here, which $7 million, I mean, damn, that sounds a lot of money. Oh yeah. But compare that to Endgame, who has like $250 million. I mean, there's no comparison. You know, $7 million sounds a lot, right? But it's very, very cheap for movies, especially, you know, a superhero movie. And I get it's a horror movie, but it's also a superhero movie. So there's one scene toward the end where Brandon does something to a character, and it just doesn't look good. I mean, it's weird, because again, the blood, and the, you know, the gory parts, and every other thing. I mean, maybe there's a few shots of the farm that look a little wonky when, you know, Elizabeth Banks' character was standing by her mailbox, and you kind of look and you go, okay, that's a green screen. But there's very few moments in this movie that were green screen, because it was literally shot on location in a small location, in a small area. So it makes perfect sense. But again, there's a few moments of the CGI where you're like, that's not too good. But again, it is a $7 million budget, but that's no excuse for it to look bad in some instances. Now, I get it. A movie's not going to look perfect all the time, you know. Even Marvel movies like Civil War, Captain Marvel, they have really bad CGI in some parts too. There's always one or two scenes in those movies that look like BS. But this movie, for being such a low budget, again, I can understand it, but I can't, you know. So I am going to have to dock a little bit for that. But anyway, guys, I loved it. I mean, God, the plot was generic, but it was really, really good, and it served its purpose. The acting was phenomenal. The special effects were great. The sound design was great. The acting was... I think I said the acting. The acting's still great. Everything in this movie really works, except for, again, there's a few scenes of editing, and there's a few CGI instances where you're going to go, it doesn't look too good. But other than that, it was hard to give this a rating, because I don't want to give it something that I don't think deserves it. But I'm going to give Brightburn an A-, as I gave Aladdin. Both very... very, very, very small negatives, but they are still negative. So I really wanted to give it an A+, because I genuinely love everything about this movie. And I frankly, I never understand why critics hate movies. I mean, unless I agree with them. But, I mean, duh. But, you know, it is opinions, you know. So if my opinion is different than yours, don't hate me. It's just my opinion. But again, don't trust me either. I always say this. Do not trust me. Go watch Brightburn for yourself, and then watch my review, and then say, okay, I agree with Franchise Fanatic, or I don't, you know. So again, it is what it is. I'm going to give Brightburn an A-. I loved it so much. I can't wait to get it on Blu-ray and unbox it for you guys. And yeah, I just thoroughly enjoyed it. It was a great horror movie, great superhero horror movie. And I hope they make a sequel, because this movie doesn't have any after-credit scene. And it lends itself to a sequel. Like, I walked out of it, and I'm like, God, I hope there's a friggin' sequel, you know. It was that damn good. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed this review. And leave me a comment in the comment section below if you enjoyed Brightburn and what you thought about it, and, you know, tell me your thoughts. Do you find it, I still can't speak. Do you find the movie scary? Like, you won't be able to go to bed tonight scary? Or do you find it just kind of scary as in the thought of an evil Superman? I kind of find it scary as in the thought of an evil Superman. I'm not gonna, you know, it's not like a ghost movie, so it's not that kind of scary. But trust me, guys, there's some jump scares that got me. And there's a lot of things that, a lot of shock tactics, I still can't speak, that you're not going to really notice, you know, you're not going to see coming. Because you've never seen a horror movie done in a superhero angle, so that's just cool. So again, keep that in mind, guys, if you go see Brightburn. Please see it. I loved it. It was a great movie. Again, can't wait to get it on Blu-ray and unbox it for you guys. I'm going to keep watching it on Blu-ray. Great movie. And yeah, I hope you guys liked this review. And again, one more time, tell me in the comments below what you thought. Did you like it? Did you not like it? Using my rating system. Thank you guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Lightsaber.